ओके हेलो एवरीवन, गुड मॉर्निंग। सो एज यू ऑल नो, लास्ट वी हैव सीन टिल नंबर 4 ऑफ एक्सरसाइज नंबर 7.2, राइट? नाउ लेट्स मूव फर्दर, नंबर 5। यस, नंबर 5, फाइंड द रेशियो इन विच द लाइन सेगमेंट जॉइनिंग ए 1-5। सो लेट्स सी नंबर 5, सॉरी, ओके। नाउ सो जॉइनिंग ए एंड बी, राइट? सो लेट एनी लाइन सेगमेंट ए बी, कोऑर्डिनेट्स ऑफ ए इज 1-5 एंड कोऑर्डिनेट्स ऑफ बी इज 4-5, राइट? So the line segment AB, joining of this AB is divided by the x-axis. Now see, अगर x-axis इसको divide करेगी, any point which lie on x-axis divide this joining, then we know that points on x-axis be like x0. Why? Because on x-axis there is a y coordinate is 0. Okay, so let P be a point which divides the joining of these two points A and B. Okay, so you have to write here P of x0. Let P of x0 divides the joining of A 1-5 and B 4-5, right? But we haven't ratio, right? That means we haven't value of M and N. Okay, find the coordinates of the point of division. Okay, that means we need to find P of x0. That means P is the point of division and we have to find the coordinates of P. So for that, by section formula, we know that what is section formula. So by section formula, okay, section formula. So we know that what is section formula, x0 equals to mx2, right? M ratio to hai nahi hamare paas. This is our x1, y1 and this is x2, y2. M, x2, x2 is -4 plus N, x1, mx2 plus nx1, mx2 plus N, x1 is 1 upon M plus N, y2 is 5 plus N, y1 is -5. Upon M plus N, right? Now equating x coordinate to x and y to y, right? So therefore x equals to -4m plus N upon M plus N, and 0 equals to 5m -5n upon M plus N, right? Now this M plus N goes to multiply with 0, right? So it will be 0. 0 into M plus N is 0. Okay, so therefore 0 equals to 5N minus 5N, and therefore 5M equals to 5N, and therefore M upon N equals to 5 upon 5. 5 upon 5, that is 1:1. So M is 1 and N is 1. Therefore M ratio N equals to 1:1. Now we have the values of M and N. So put these values in this form, so we get the value of X. Okay, so now therefore X equals to -4 in place of M 1 plus 1 upon MX2 plus upon m plus n, that is 1 plus 1 x equals to minus 4, 1 is a minus 4, plus 1 upon m plus n is 1 plus 1, right? Minus 4 plus 1 is minus 3, upon 1 plus 1 is 2. So x is minus 3 by 2, right? Therefore, the point of division is P of x0, that is P of minus 3 by 2, 0. Okay? So this is the solution. Now, move to the sixth one, if 1, 2, 4, y, x, 6 and 3, 5 are the vertices of a parallelogram. So, before solve this sum, we have some ideas. And obviously, आपको parallelogram की properties भी आनी चाहिए, right? So, you know about properties of parallelogram, and that is opposite sides are equal and parallel, and diagonals bisect each other, right? So, by using this property, let first point A, 1, 2, then second point B, 4, y, third point C, x, 6, and fourth point D, 3, 5, right, are the vertices of parallelogram taken in order, that means order mein hai ye, okay? So suppose we have a parallelogram ABCD, right? So diagonals BD bisect AC or AC bisect BD, that means both are bisect each other, that means this is the midpoint of both the diagonals, okay? And we know that how to find the coordinates of midpoint, right? So let P be any midpoint of AC as well as BD, right? So here you need to equate them. So midpoint of AC equals to midpoint of BD, right? Chalo, AC ka midpoint. So midpoint of AC, that is x1 plus x2 by 2 and y1 plus y2 by 2. So that is 1 plus x by 2 and 2 plus 6 by 2. Midpoint of BD, 4 plus 3 by 2, y plus 5 by 2. Okay, now equate x to x coordinate, y to y coordinate. So 1 plus x by 2 equals to 4 plus 3, that is 7 by 2, and y 2 plus 6, yani 8 by 2, equals to y plus 5 by 2. Chalo, yahan se ye 2 to cut, 2 to cut, right? Now 1 plus x equals to 7, therefore x equals to 7 minus 1, and y equals to 8 minus 5, therefore x equals to 6 and y equals to 3. Okay, so these are the values of x and y. Now number 7, find the coordinates of point A where AB is the diameter. Okay, ye aapko homework mein karna hai. See, AB is a diameter. AB is the diameter. Let O be any center, right? Now see, center is 2 minus 3 and B is 1, 4, right? So we haven't this A, coordinates of A. So let x, y, right? Now we know that O is midpoint of AB. So by midpoint formula, you get coordinates of A easily, right? So यहाँ पे आपको ये मिल जाएगा. Now, yes, okay. Number 8. Eighth one, if A and B are -2, -2 and 2, -4 respectively, see. Suppose A -2, -2, B -2, -4. Right? Respectively, find the coordinates of P such that AB equals to 3/7 of AB. That means P जो पॉइंट है वो AB line segment के ऊपर कहीं पे lie कर रहा है, ठीक है? But we haven't its coordinate, so let us suppose XY. Now what is given here? AP equals to 3/7 of AB, right? So now take this AB left side, so AP upon AB equals to 3/7. That means AP is 3. This one is 3. AP upon AB. AB is 7. That means this whole AB is 7. Okay. So this is 7 and this is 3. So PB will be 4. Right? Now we have the value of M and N. M is 3, N is 4, X1, Y1, X2, Y2. तो सेक्शन फार्मूला में सारी वैल्यू सब्स्टिट्यूट कर दो. सो आपको यहाँ पे पॉइंट पी के कोऑर्डिनेट्स मिल जाएंगे, राइट? नाउ नाइन्थ नंबर का जो सम है वो आपको होमवर्क में, आई होप कि मैंने लास्ट लेक्चर में बोला होगा कि ट्राई सेक्शन का जो हमने सेकेंड नंबर का सम किया था उसमें रेशियो हमने इक्वल लिया था. दैट मीन्स 1:1:1. सो नाइन्थ नंबर का जो सम है उसमें देखो 4 इक्वल पार्ट्स है, राइट? सो 4 इक्वल पार्ट्स है, दैट मीन्स वहाँ पे आपको 1:1:1:1. आपको कोई भी लाइन सेगमेंट में जितने भी पार्ट्स बोले गए मोर देन 2, ऐसे ट्राई सेक्शन है, 4 पार्ट्स है, 5 पार्ट्स है, राइट? सो आपको वहाँ पे रेशियो जो है वो इक्वल ही लेना है, ठीक है? सो जैसे हमने सेकेंड किया था वैसे 9 नंबर का सम भी आपको होमवर्क में करना है. Now move to the 10th. Find the area of a rhombus if its vertices are. Now rhombus, so we know this properties of rhombus, but we need to find here area of rhombus. So what is the formula for finding the area of rhombus? So area of rhombus equals to 1/2 product of diagonals. Okay, so let us suppose ABCD is a rhombus, right? A is 3, 0, B is 4, 5, C -2, -1, and D, 3, 0, 4, 5, -1, 4. This is -1, 4, and D will be -2, -1. Okay, now, so formula is 1/2 product of diagonals. So we need to find first diagonals. So we know that there are two diagonals, AC and BD, right? So how to find AC and BD? So by distance formula, right? So AC equals to square root of distance formula, we know that, right? 3 -1 square, that is 3 + 1 square plus 0 - 4 square. Okay, now see, 3 + 1, that is 4 square, 4 square is 16, plus 0 - 4, again 4, right? -4 square is 16, and 16 plus 16, 32, right? So we can write as 32, that is 16, 2s are 16 jo hai, take it outside of square roots, so it will be 4 root 2 units, okay? Similarly, find next diagonal BD. So BD, 4 minus minus 2, that is 4, 4 minus minus 2, that is 4 plus 2 square, plus 5 minus minus 1, that is 5 plus 1 square, okay? Chalo. So yahan pe ho jayega 4 plus 2 square plus 5 plus 1 square. Now, 4 plus 2, that is 6 square, 6 square is 36, plus 5 plus 1 square, again 36, 6 square is 36, right? So 36 in plus 36, we can write as 36 2s are 36, take it outside, so it will be 6 root 2 units, right? Now, area of rhombus. Area of rhombus, that is 1 by 2 product of diagonals. So we have two diagonals AC and BD. So AC and BD, uska product yani multiplication, 1 by 2 AC is 4 root 2 into BD is 6 root 2. Now root 2 into root 2 is 2, and this 2 will be cut, right? So remains 4, 6 are 24. So 24 square units. So this is the area of rhombus, okay? So here your exercise number 7.2 is over now, okay? So in next lecture, we'll find the area of triangle, okay? So your today's homework is complete classwork in notebook till exercise number 7.2, and also examples 1 minute, yes, 6 to 10, okay, and examples 6 to 10. So see you next lecture with the new topic. Till then, goodbye and take care.